Welcome to the fifth video of the Blender 2.8 beginners tutorial series. In this video, we will on the one hand model a bowl, some wooden planks for the ground, and then we will use these as collision object for a simple cloth simulation to create this piece of fabric. However, we will not create the frayed edges. This we will do later when texturing this piece of fabric. As always, you can find the timestamps in the video description below, and there you will also find the link to sign up to our resource section free of charge to get access to all the project files, videos, and our handy Blender 2.8 shortcut PDF. Hi everyone, Zach here for cgboost.com, and let's get started. Alright, let's start by modeling the bowl. For that, I won't use any reference, since it should be a very simple object, and I have two objects in my scene already, which I can use as scale reference. So I will scale the bowl so that this fits to the rest of the scene. First of all, let's zoom back a bit, hit Shift A, and add a UV sphere. So the subdivisions here, the segments and rings are fine. First of all, let's scale this down a bit. I open the sidebar by pressing N so I can see how big this will be. Let's scale it down. And I think something like 25 centimeters is fine. Let's apply the scale, Control A. Let's take a look from the front view. And I added this sphere here because if I cut this in half, I basically have the bowl nearly finished already. So let's tap into edit mode, make sure that X-ray is enabled, and let's select the upper part, press X, and in this case I delete the vertices, and then you can see that the connected faces and edges will also be deleted. That's why I didn't select the whole upper half. Now let's select the lower part here, press S for scaling, lock this along the Z-axis, and then simply hit zero on the numpad. Then basically everything will be scaled down to one flat plane. Confirm this by left clicking and then press G for moving, press Z to lock this along the Z axis and move it up a bit. Now look at this. This already looks like a nice little bowl. Now let's disable X-ray. And now I want to add some interesting parts down here. Let's use the Inset Face tool. The whole thing is still selected. Left click somewhere in the 3D space and hold and then move it to the inside. You can see it's basically an extrusion to the inside. Then use the extrude region tool or simply press E and move it down a bit. Something like this. Then with Alt left click, let's select this loop up here. Press E again. When it's not automatically locked along an axis, you can still press Z, for example, to lock this. Move this up a bit and press S, scale it a bit bigger. So now let's tap back to object mode, and I don't want to have the bowl which is too high, so let's press S, then Z, lock this along the Z axis and make this a bit shorter, something like this. Control A, apply the scale. Now we have a little problem here because you can see when I move this up, the origin, that means the kind of center point of the object, is somewhere up here. And if I, for example, rotate this, it's rotating around this point. And there's a quick way to change the position of this. Let's go to front view, tap into edit mode, select everything, go back to select box here, then press G for moving, Z for the Z axis, and simply move this up. And you can see this little orange dot will stay where it is. And now I can basically move it to the bottom of the bowl, just roughly. It doesn't have to be perfect. And if I now tap back to object mode, you can see this origin is now down here, and it's way easier for me to place this somewhere. And also if I press Alt G to reset the position of this object, this will always set the origin of the object back to 000 of the location. And now it stands kind of on the ground. And this just makes working with this easier. Now, before we go on, make sure that you applied the scale, because now we will work with modifiers. First of all, you can see we don't have a smooth surface and we don't have thickness. And since I don't want to add thickness in edit mode, this is a bit complicated, we will do this with modifiers. So let's select the bowl, go to the modifiers, add modifier, and add a solidify modifier. As you can see, this will add thickness, and I can change the thickness over here. I hold down Shift, then left click on this value and move my mouse left and right to precisely change this value. Now let's collapse this and add a bevel modifier. And the cool thing is the modifiers interact with each other. So if I add the solidify first, the bevel modifier will use everything the solidify modifier generates and then have an effect on that and not on the original model. So the order of the modifiers are very important. So now I added this beveled edge, but this looks kind of weird. First of all, you can see it will add the beveled edge everywhere. So let's go to a limit method and click on angle. Now again, this will limit the beveled edge to a certain angle, which we can set up here. So everything above 30 degrees will get a bevel. Let's reduce the width here to better see what's going on. So now you can see we have this nice bevel over here. And now as last modifier, I add a subdivision surface modifier. Let's increase the viewport subdivisions. And why I added the bevel? Because, as I mentioned before, when two edges are very close to each other, the subsurf modifier will create a harder edge. So for example, if I disable the bevel modifier, you can see this is very roundish. But if I now enable this, we get a harder edge. And it's even more important down here, because without the bevel modifier, this would look something like this. And if I enable this, it is harder. But the edge is not hard enough. So what we can do, let's quickly disable the subsurf modifier. And certainly we can make this smaller, but this won't end up making the edge really sharp. We can add another segment. So basically add another cut in between. And now these edges are very close to each other. And that means if I enable the subsurf modifier, we get a very hard edge down here. It shouldn't be like perfectly sharp, but it should have just a little bit of a bevel, and then you can see it up here. This looks really nice. You can see how this behaves when I change the width of the bevel. So, and the last thing I do, right click, shade smooth. And now look at this wonderful looking bowl. Let's change the name over here to bowl and make sure to save the blend file. So for our scene, we certainly need something where all these objects stand on. And I want to have a feel that all these objects certainly stand on a table, a wooden table. So let's create some wooden planks. With Shift A, I add a simple cube, press N, and I tried this before and I have an idea how this should look like. So I want to have the X direction 2 meters. This is totally fine. I want to have a width of 15 centimeters and a height of, let's use 1.5 centimeters. In the end, we won't see the height anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Then zoom in a bit, press G, Z for moving, and then move it down so that the top part is roughly on the red line, because the red line will be roughly our ground plane. So now we have this very simple wooden plank here. Let's press Ctrl A and apply the scale. And now I show you a new modifier. Let's move this to the side and let's add an array modifier. And the array modifier creates duplicates of the original object in a certain direction. Right now the X direction is enabled, but in this case this doesn't make sense, so let's set this back to 0 and use the Y direction instead. So you can see it's now going in this direction, so let's use -1. And between all the duplicates I want to have a little gap. So let's increase the value to maybe -1.01, and then we have this little gap, and then this really looks like we have wooden planks here. Let's increase this maybe to 15. Certainly we can change this later on if we need to. And if I zoom in here, now I also want to add this little beveled edge to make this just look nicer. So what I do, again, I add a bevel modifier, decrease the width quite a bit. Then again, right click, shade smooth. But you can see that this looks kind of weird. So we do the same thing as we did for the blade of the knife. We enable harden normals. And down here we enable auto smooth. And now we have this like perfect looking beveled edges over here. Let's call this object wood. And now let's already move the objects so that they are roughly on the ground so that we better can see them. And for now, let's move the knife and the apple to the side and select the bowl. And since the origin is down here, we can simply press Alt G to reset this to the center of the scene. And now it's basically standing perfectly in the center here. So, and now we do a little claw simulation with a piece of fabric we want to throw over the bulb just to make the scene a little bit more interesting. So what we do, first of all, I hide the apple and the knife. Then with Shift A, I add a simple plane. Let's move this up a bit. Press N. Let's set the dimensions to 50 centimeters for X and Y. I already tried this. This size works quite well for this scene. And then with Shift A, I apply the scale. Then let's tap into edit mode, right click since everything is selected, and then I click on subdivide. Now the mesh will be subdivided as you can see. Let's increase the number of cuts down here to 50. I think 50 is good. Let's tap back to object mode, take a look from above, and let's quickly enable X-ray so we can see the bowl down here and just move it somewhere here. So very important is that the fabric is above the bowl here so that we can run the claw simulation because gravity is taking an effect on the claws and then it will fall down. Let's disable X-ray. Let's hide the sidebar. And now we need the timeline. And for that, we can simply move over to the animation workspace. Now you can see we have the timeline down here, which is important to play the simulation. So, and for playing the simulation, we need to tell the objects what role they have in the simulation. So for example, the bowl down here should be a collision object. So I select this, then I go over to the physics tab and simply enable collision. We have a bunch of options down here, but all in all, we can just leave the default settings enabled. And I do the same thing for the ground for the wooden planks here. So I select these and then I enable collision. So, and this plane up here should be the fabric. So I select this and enable the claw simulation. So again, down here we have many, many settings we can change, but we leave everything as it is, except under collision, we also enable self-collision. That means when the object creates folds and these folds fall into each other, then they don't clip through each other, then basically everything looks nicer. So simply enable this. And all you need to do to run the simulation is to playback the animation. And now you see how this falls down and looks very nice. If you have a position which looks nice, you can simply stop this. But you can see that from above, this looks a little bit too perfect for me. So I move this back to the beginning here, tap into edit mode. And first of all, let's enable the proportional editing. If you don't see this little icon here, you can hold down middle mouse button and move this around so you can see all the buttons. So let's click on that. We used proportional editing for creating the upper and lower part of the apple. Now I simply left click and select a vertex and move this up a bit, this down a bit, just to create a little bit of random shape so that the folds later on will fold a little bit differently. Then let's tap out of edit mode, go to the top view, and also let's press R twice. Then we have the ability to rotate this object freely. And let's just rotate this, I don't know, something like this. And then when we now run the simulation, basically all the folds will fold a bit differently. So let's play back the animation here and see how this will work. So important is that this piece of cloth is falling into the bowl and not covering the top part because we want to place some apples in there. So we need a bit of space. So maybe let's try it once again. Once again, I tap into edit mode, change this a bit more. And maybe move it from the top view a bit more over here. And let's try one more time. So now let's stop the simulation. And I think this looks quite fine to me. So this is now not a static object. That means as soon as you change anything here in the timeline, this will start again to simulate the whole thing. So what we need to do, we need to tell this object that this should now be a static object. So in this, we can do by simply selecting the object, go to the modifiers, and as you can see, as soon as we enable the claw simulation for this object, it creates this claw modifier. And here we have this nice apply button. So if I click on this, the current position will be applied as static object. You can see the modifier disappears, and over here, the claw simulation is also disabled. Then let's select the ground and disable the collision. and the same for the bowl. Let's go back to the layout workspace. And if I select this thing over here, it still looks too rough. So what we do, let's go to the modifiers and let's simply add a subdivision surface modifier. Let's increase the viewport subdivisions and right click, let's shade this smooth. And now you can see this looks fantastic. Let's rename this into fabric. Let's enable the apple and the knife. And now we have all the objects we need here. Don't forget to save this. So guys, now you have a rough idea on how to use a cloth simulation in Blender. There's certainly a lot more you can do with that, but here we don't want to make this too complicated. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe and leave a comment below and ring the bell underneath this video if you want to get notified for future videos. If you want to get even deeper into Blender 2.8, check out our Blender 2.8 Launchpad course. There we will not only create a full scene from scratch, we will also take a look on the most important pain points and pitfalls for beginners in Blender. So check it out, link down below in the video description. Thanks a lot for watching guys, now check the next video where we will UV unwrap the apple and the knife. If you don't know what UV unwrapping is, watch the video. I will see you there, goodbye.